So this video is gonna finally gonna do the China video on this, but I've been wanting to talk about this a lot because I just don't think sometimes we see the bigger picture here. But we'll talk a little bit about the impeachment and the impeachment. Truth of the matter is, I think it's complete waste of our time, complete waste of our money. And the thing that makes me the most sick is there's an elite pedophile ring out there that are doing horrific things to kids, and we're all turning a blind eye. Jeffrey Epstein did not kill himself. It's not, I mean, come on, bro, you know. And you got another country over there that is abusing power left and right. They're selling people's organs. They have concentration camps set up right now where they're forcing Muslims to eat beef, or be beef, I'm sorry, eat pork, and all these horrific things going on. And yet we're worried about something that is nothing. And Trump has been attacked since day one. He's never been given a fair shot. From day one, everyone has been trying to gun after him. It's been a witch hunt. Mueller investigation, you know, absolutely nothing. When he named Kavanaugh as the Supreme Court Justice, bashed him. I've never seen this before, and it just blows my mind. And now we're going after something that does not have extreme merit. You listen to the phone conversations there, and he's like beating around the kind of bush kind of thing. It's not enough. I understand where people are coming from. I'm not really like super leaning one way or the other, but I am pretty in the middle. I do lean more conservative because of, you know, business interests, but I am liberally social in the sense of like, yeah, man, I don't want to see anyone's freedoms taken away ever, you know? And that's one of the things right now that I'm drawn more to the Republican parties. I feel like they are protecting our freedom of speech a little bit more and not policing us. Sometimes there's a horrific shit out there, and I don't want people to say, you know, like, bad things like, you know, the N-word or you know, even, you know, call me certain things or whatever, you know. But the truth of the matter is us as the public, people like me and you, we have to decide in our society what's accepted or not. Obviously, we all decided, you know, slavery eventually was not accepted. We could have been a lot faster about that. But, you know, yeah, we also decided it's okay if you are in love with, you know, the opposite sex. That doesn't affect me. It doesn't really affect anyone. I'm happy for them, you know. But you gotta let society decide that. We cannot let government come in and let us, in a sense, force us to think of a certain way or do a certain way, because we're gonna be exactly like how this country I'm about to talk to, or about to talk about, is. So, I mean, I could do a whole video on that thing, but we're gonna let that. Let's talk about China. Let's talk about what it is. Okay, so. They're intertwined with each other. So, you know, they're communists, right? So whatever they say goes. They control speech. They can ban videos. They can flip your life upside down whenever they want. The one thing that no president has done that Trump has is he's taken them head on in the trade war, because they have freaking ripped us off left and right. You could even Google like fake Apple stores, you know, instead of Starbucks, they got T-Bucks. They don't care. They don't care, and they're just like, you know, and at the end of the day, man, it's like, all right, they're trying to do their hustle, but it's not fair that we invest billions of dollars into tech. They're like, hey, you want to trade here? You want to open something here? You got to share with us what it is that you're doing, right? And a lot of people are misconceiving what he means. Like, what does he mean by devaluing, like, currency and this and that? So this is a huge problem that I had with him once, you know, you start figuring it out. In a sense is, when you want to devalue something, like we talked about in our videos about inflation and what goes up, is because the Fed prints money and you have to, you know. Okay, anyways, like, basically all they do is they see, like, oh, wow, like, we have a lot of investment. A lot of Nike factories and Apple factories are opening here. Oh, they're, maybe they're not paying them, you know, $20 an hour, but they started off paying them, like, $1 an hour. Now it's up to, hypothetical here, $2 to $3 an hour. Things start getting better. People start consuming more. That currency starts getting stronger. As it gets closer to the American dollar, American companies are like, yo, Korea, what's good with you? Hey, you know, Africa, what's up? India, what's good? You know, like, let's move around. Hey, Malaysia, what's up? And China wants to have that control because they want those American dollars to come in. They want to keep it. So what do? They print more yuan. They print more of their currency. So it devalues their dollars. It keeps their goods cheaper. It's cheaper for labor, cheaper for their goods, and we continue to buy, everyone continue to buy, and they continue to hold. And they use that excess dollars to go buy influence in the world. And what they're doing right now, quite simply, is they're trying to buy up UN seats. If you look at the map, and you know, they're very sneaky, man. Like, I don't trust them, because I can't trust someone. If I can't tell you what I think about you as a human being or as a person, or comment on it, whether you like me or not, you know, I wouldn't say something disrespectful, but I could say, hey man, I don't really like the way you're doing that. If I can't do that without you retaliating physically and beating me up and imprisoning me, I don't trust you, man. I'm sorry. Because if anything that needs to be done in the dark, or you need to be quiet about, that's not something that, you know, I want to partake in, right? So that's the main reason why I don't really trust anything they do. So basically what they're doing is they're going into these countries. Like, I visited Malaysia this year, so I'll give you a real life example. We visited the US Embassy there. And you know, they have a One Belt Road initiative. So back in the day, they used to call it the Silk Road. And when I mean back in the day, I mean China was the biggest world power, guys. Don't make any mistake about it. They've been asleep for 100 years, and they're coming back with a freaking force. And if we're not ready to meet them with that force, your American way of life, the way you like it, the way you have things going here, it's not going to be that way. We'll get there. Back in the day with the Silk Road, you know, all the trades and routes and everything used to go through China. And they were the biggest country in, you know, in the world at the time, you know. Now they're building the One Belt Road initiative, where they're doing projects all over, and all ports and all roads lead right back to China. So for example, Malaysia, we had influence, we're helping them contract it. China's building a road there, and if you know Malaysia geographically, we were in Kuala Lumpur, their capital, but they have their little city that borders Singapore, which is one of the biggest ports in the world. They're building a road or a train from those ports that China is going to control all the way back up to China. And in the contract, it was kind of fishy. They never really put details, and this is what the American embassy is working on right now, is they're trying to get these guys to say, what happens if we miss a payment? Are you going to be able to quietly just take over our land and just say, oh, well, you know, you didn't pay, this our rail, this our country now, right? Does it go into default? Like, what happens? It's not really being done. And what these guys are doing is they're going in, they're pumping their money into it, and they're buying that influence, and they're being able to do what they want around the world. Why does all this affect you and me? And why is it important that we put the pedal to the metal of these guys? The truth is, I think there's a dollar shortage in the world. It's like something like $6 trillion are only floated around outside of global circulation here. And it's a fight for dollars, because everyone loves America. Nah, it's because we trust America, man. Like, as crazy our politics are, as crazy as you think Trump is or Pelosi is or whatever, we trust our politics here. We trust our system. You know, we trust everything we talked about in that prior video, the mystery of capital. We have property rights. We're not going to just lock you up just because you say something that someone doesn't like. We're not going to, like, you know what I mean? It's stable. And that's for now the power we have. But right now, gold's out of the picture. Right now, I meant to say oil, thinking liquid gold. You know, but that's settled right now in dollars. Slowly but surely, what China's trying to do is, once it gets enough influence everywhere and they built their things, they want to have their dollar bill become the American dollar. Right now, we could just print, right? Build that wall, whatever, build this, you know, whatever the heck you want to build. It's all good, baby. It's all gravy. Let's just keep printing, and no one says anything. No one checks us. $22 trillion in debt. It's because we're the world leader. We got the biggest on the block, the biggest stick on the block, right? But these guys are coming, and given enough time, and they get influence in these regions, and all of a sudden, when we put sanctions on somebody, it doesn't mean anything. Like, screw you. Hey, I'm Iran. You don't want to let me build a nuclear weapon? Oh, you're gonna sanction me? It's cool. I'll go trade with China, man. I'll trade with China. We'll trade with Russia. We'll trade with India, because they got to connect here. We don't even need America. We're gonna put them out. You get put out, I mean, our whole lifestyles can change. You could see our whole country crumble in that sense, or at least lose a lot of clout, a lot of influence. And China also does other things on the South Asian Sea. So they share that border, and all these natural resources are supposed to be, you know, like 100 miles in. These guys went out and built a freaking island to extend their reach. And they're playing war games there, and they're constantly provoking us. And it's kind of like, you know, on the surface, like, oh, we're your friend, we're your buddy, man, what's good? But at the same time, you're like, yo, you're my friend, you're my buddy, but yet in your own country, you don't let people speak out about you. You let, even you told Mayor Bloomberg, who's now running for president, hey, if you don't shut up and stop printing articles about us, we're going to remove all the Bloomberg terminals here, right? You manipulate us. You manipulate us by using our richest people in the world here. You use people that are elites, that are billionaires. You give them access to your market. I'm talking about China here. And then you turn around and tell them, hey, you better shut up about us if you want to continue to do business here. So you don't see most billionaires speaking out about it, I guess, except for the orange man. The orange man with the wig or whatever the heck it is. He's the only one that's saying, you know what, this shit ain't right. And my fear is the America that we got to enjoy, the peace and the prosperity that we got to enjoy the most part. Yeah, we went to war with Iraq. Yeah, we went to war with Afghanistan. But my generation, we might be screwed with college debt. We might be screwed with, you know, having too much social media depressing us, whatever. But dang it, at least we got to live, man. You know, because of that flag right there and the people that fought for it, we had the freedom to be able to say what we wanted to say. I'm able to stand here in front of you and talk about this openly. And I don't have to fear persecution. I don't have to fear going to jail. I don't have to fear these things that a lot of people in the world have to fear, man. A lot of people in the world have to fear this. A lot of people in the world don't even get, you know, clean water. A lot of people in the world don't get to eat at night. And we have been blessed because of capitalism. You know, whatever you want to say about capitalism, whatever you want to say about America, just know that everything that you're looking at while you're looking at this video has been done because of capitalism. iPhones have made the world a better, that's arguable, but you've got an iPhone, you know, we've gotten TVs for cheap. Our quality of life has gone up. And that's because, at its root, the Constitution, America, everything was founded on. At its root, we've done a lot of bad shit. I'm not denying that. I mean, come on, man, just like slavery and just even then 1964 for just civil rights, man, you know, come on, dude. And even all the dirty stuff that we've done, like manipulated elections and taking powers out, putting powers in. I mean, I'm not saying we're a perfect country, but for its citizens, America does try to do the right thing. It has afforded us one of the best opportunities in the world. And I'm truly am scared and fearful that, you know, I think we're going to lose it. And I think that we have so much pride and we have this blindness that we're more worried about, you know, electing someone who's going to give us free health care and free whatever. There's a reason why we're number one. There's a reason why we don't have that. There's a reason why the top companies in the world are produced here. The most wealth is kept here is because we've only been able to fend for ourselves. And we took pride in doing stuff ourselves. We've never relied on a government or somebody to take care of us. But the more we start spending here, the more we start spending on ourselves, the less power we have in our military, less influence we have. And if China gains control, man, I don't think we're going to be able to be in a position to tell them what to do. I think we lose trade. I think we lose the value of the dollar. We lose the value of the dollar. We're going to be struggling like all these other countries. Our currency isn't going to mean as much as it does. We can't just bail ourselves out by printing more money. The one faith that I do have is the fact that property rights exist here. The fact that we have that trust, we kept that investment here. But as this climate starts getting more left, as these laws might change, like, you don't need to own 10 rentals. Why do you have $1 billion? You have $1 billion because you deployed, that person deployed the capital in the best freaking way. That's why they have $1 billion. They took that money, they made more money with it, and they hold that money because they're going to continue to deploy it the perfect way. That person having $1 billion does not affect the way you live. It does not affect you going out and having a drink with your buddy, or enjoying your life, or whatever. It does not make you more miserable. Stop looking at other people's crap. Worry about yourself. But the China thing, that does scare me in the long run, because I'm afraid that I'm going to have to live, or we're all going to have to live in a world where our kids are not going to be able to enjoy this peace and prosperity. And I feel like we've been blinded by it, and I feel like we've been led astray, and I feel that some people just don't see the bigger picture. I'm not claiming I know more than you. I could be totally wrong. I'd love to hear your opinion on it. I'd probably read the comments. But that's just my thoughts and my heads and my vision and my way of thinking. And I try to make it as logical and reasonable as possible, because the dollar does make the world go around until China gains more clout and makes their currency become the new dollar. And their initiatives are very, very ambitious. I just touched on the tip of the iceberg. Just Google China's plans, you know, to 2030, 2050, and see what they're doing and see what we're doing. You know, I'll talk about a race to 5G in one of the videos. It's going to be pretty nuts, but blow your mind kind of thing. But hey, don't take offense into what I said. These are just my opinions. I could be wrong. But these are just my thoughts, and I respect your thoughts if you think the opposite thing, but I guess we could just respectfully disagree. And if you didn't, I hope you learned something.